Hi, my name is Greg Badros. I'm the founder of Gluroo, which is a mobile diabetes management solution that works like a messaging app. Thanks, Amy, for inviting me here to tell you a bit about what we've been up to the last 2 years. So, about 30 months ago, our 7-year-old son was super thirsty, going to the bathroom all the time, and not feeling great. His doctor did a urinalysis test, looked at it, and said, "This can't be right. That is definitely not something you want to hear your doctor say." And well, you know the drill. We got a finger prick reading of 481, and that's a quick ticket to the Stanford emergency room. We didn't know anything about diabetes yet, but we did learn quickly, and we're fortunate that Stanford was able to get us set up with a Dexcom G6 sensor, and we started using tools like XTrip and Night Scout right away. I even started building my own tools pretty early on, including a ceiling projection of my son's Dexcom reading. So this 11.3 degrees was actually a blood glucose of 113. And I got an adapted G6 app to run on a full Android smartwatch with a SIM card so we could still follow his numbers without him needing to carry a phone. The available solutions for logging, though, weren't really what we were looking for. SugarMate was one of the better ones, but it was iOS only. And everything felt really clunky to do simple data entry in and didn't really handle the whole workflow around managing diabetes, especially like in our situation when multiple caregivers were helping the person with diabetes. The apps that were out there really were strongly biased towards adult users and had an expectation of each user just using a single device, and all the state was local to that device. Well, this all started during the pandemic. Or just at the start of the pandemic when we weren't leaving the house much at all. So we resigned ourselves to just paper logging to track everything. It really was the easiest and the fastest, but it wasn't without its problems. To help make sure we didn't correct nighttime highs, for example, we'd first leave the insulin pen downstairs at the kitchen table until the first correction of the night was needed, and only after that moved it upstairs and left it there. So that we could tell the difference between the first correction and the second correction and talk about it if we needed to. Pretty quickly, I started to realize that there had to be a better way. And for an engineer, and me in particular, this phrase is both a bit of a mantra and a call to action. One of the things we noticed we started trying to improve upon was by using Facebook Messenger as a log of diabetes events. We'd use shorthand like 1 SV to mean a single starburst as an intervention snack, or something more complicated like this would record both an estimate of carbs and giving a bolus for that meal. Now, I didn't really introduce myself thoroughly before, but as we're talking about the product vision for Gluroo, my background is relevant here. About 8 years ago, I started a tech advising company, and for that business, I made some old-fashioned business cards. I used a strip of colors along the right edge as a shout-out to the early chapters of my life. I was math and computer science double major at Duke with a concentration in psych, then earned my PhD at the UW in Seattle with my thesis related to constraint-based layout of user interfaces. A decade later, that cassowary constraint solver was adopted by Apple as the auto layout system that's been used on iOS from very early on. In 2003, I moved to California and joined Google and spent 6 years there running engineering teams on things like AdSense and later Google Apps. And in 2009, I joined Facebook, where I spent just over 4 years running ads, search, data science, infrastructure, and more. And the more part is important to this story. I worked on communication products both at Google, where it was Gmail, and Facebook, where years later I had an interim stint as director of Messenger. So when I had a free weekend in August 2020, I used that background and this inspiration of messaging as a framework to begin to build a mobile app to help our family manage our son's condition. At its heart, Gluroo is a messaging-first application that supports the web, Android, and of course, iOS devices too. Gluroo is deeply domain-specific so that it's able to help support the everyday workflows around diabetes. That means it has to integrate with the things people are already using to manage their care, like Dexcom's G6 and Abbott's Freestyle Libre sensors, and pumps such as Insulet's Omnipod Dash system and the do-it-yourselfer's favorite iOS Loop app. Now, when I say that Gluroo is cross-platform, I don't just mean that there's a single app that can run on both iOS and Android. Gluroo is designed for a team of caregivers working together. Even if mom has a Pixel 4, dad has a Samsung Galaxy phone, and kiddo's using an iPhone 8. Gluroo is a polished, complete, and featureful application with an easy onboarding process to get you going. Today, I'm just going to highlight its truly differentiating features. And the first key difference is that Gluroo is a messaging application. So fundamentally, I believe that managing diabetes is mostly about tracking and communicating the state of all things that influence blood sugar. Most other apps are built around the notion of a log, but the affordances of a log are rather stale and, frankly, isolating. Messaging, especially when there are other people involved in the process of care, messaging evokes a sense of audience and triggers our innate social need to connect and communicate with others as we're tracking relevant events. This lesson that having an audience increases engagement was proven by Mark and my former teams at Facebook and by the teams at Twitter over the last decade or so, and it's a fundamental part of Gluroo. Gluroo makes it super easy to build up someone's Gluroo. That's the team of people supporting them. Here's an Android phone in dark mode, but it's not just about that one device. They're inviting an iPhone user on the right to join the Gluroo using a QR code. Now, this, of course, works via email, too, but that's less fun to demonstrate. Now, once we have a Gluroo set up, even if it's just you, you see what should be a fairly familiar messaging interface with a couple of changes. Here we have a person with diabetes Android phone on the left and a parent's iPhone on the right in the regular theme. In Gluroo, the top header shows the profile pic of the person with diabetes prominently in the center. From inside the vertical dots overflow menu, you can see the profile pic of the person using the phone and notice Susie on the left and her mom Terry on the right on the iPhone. Back to the header, on the left side we have a stacked display of estimated carbs on board on top in yellow and estimated insulin on board beneath in blue. Now on the right side of the header, we have the latest blood glucose value from the CGM or the latest finger prick reading. Here, we see Susie entering her dinner just using natural language, providing a carb estimate of 45 grams. She could provide more details, but when she sends that message, it shows up on her mom Terry's iPhone, and both messages get annotated, not just with a timestamp, but also with her current blood glucose level. Her mom responds and adds to the meal log with another 35 grams for dessert, and we see both of those entries update the carbs on board status in the top left for a total of 80 grams. Gluroo's NLP engine is pretty powerful and lets you not only do data entry, but also set the time of those entries. So, for example, you can log something in the past super fast by just using the shorthand 15M ago. You can do hours ago, days ago, whatever. There's lots of options. Typing log entries is super fast after you get the hang of it, but sometimes, especially when you're learning, a more guided approach might be easier. So we also support tap-based logging. The plus button on the bottom left here gets you started. And here we see Susie adding a carb entry. She's easily able to see and choose from recent meals, or can enter something new with as much or as little detail as she wants. Here's an example of her using the plus menu to enter an exercise. She enters the duration just by a couple of taps, and then she can provide extra details using the text box so that she and Gluroo can better understand how tennis with, in this case, Bob, affects her blood glucose levels. Plain text messages are useful, but can be a bit dry. At Facebook, interestingly, the day every year that we got the most engagement from our users was actually the day after Halloween. Everybody was checking their friends' photos from the night before. Gluroo 2 supports photos. You simply tap the camera button in the bottom left, and then, well, you take a photo. You can add notes yourself before sending, or you can just send it and let Gluroo's image analysis and recognition AI suggest labels for you to add and include in the entry. Here, Gluroo recognizes a popcorn, and Susie adds that suggested popcorn label, and the whole Gluroo's history shows the photo and its label. If you prefer, you can just scan the UPC code of the popcorn box and enter that into your log. It's that easy. The scanning works great for devices and supplies, too. Here I'm putting on a new sensor and want to record the lot number and code number. With Gluroo, it's actually faster for me to do that than it is for me to explain what I'm doing. Now, those supply messages aren't just for fun. They actually come in handy later on. You can view your device status and tap report if a sensor fails early. That lets Gluroo open up the Dexcom support webpage and pre-fills that form based on the device details you've already logged and your other info, so you can get a new sensor on its way in about 6 seconds flat. Thanks, Dexcom. Now, we of course don't get everything right the first time that we're logging, so Gluroo lets you update and edit the log however you need to. We can select the message by long pressing on it and edit it in place to update the log. Or on another message, we can simply swipe left varying distances to indicate that the message happened, in this case, 15 minutes earlier. Any member of the Gluroo can edit and remove messages, all immediately synchronizing across devices. Now, it's important to understand that the state synchronization that's happening inside the app isn't just for messages. Here, Sweetie is looking at the Gluroo member list, and her mom, Teresa, on the right, edits her profile and sets her preferred name, Terry. Her name updates on her child's phone just moments after she finishes her edit. All of the state in Gluroo works just like this. Now, if a device becomes disconnected so that the state is not being synchronized, Gluroo makes that situation very clear. Gluroo is not for making medical decisions, but we do want to be sure folks understand when what they're looking at may not be the most recent data. Now, as the messages are sent, as with most messaging apps, notifications get sent to the other members of the Gluroo. These notifications are just regular operating system notifications, and you can even respond in line to these messages directly without ever opening Gluroo. We want you to spend the minimum amount of time in the app and maximize the quality and quantity of logging that you can do. Gluroo's most important notifications are alerts. And there are two really different things about Gluroo's alerts. First is that you don't dismiss alerts. All alerts are actionable, and you log what you did to make the alert go away. This is an important difference. Here we see a high alert in the app, and that alert bar makes it easy to record the corrective action the person with diabetes took. When the insulin dose is sent, that alert ends for the whole Gluroo and is synchronized across the devices. With Gluroo, we require you continue using the first party alerting system of your sensor. So the second way Gluroo improves upon alerting is to minimize the number of additional alerts that Gluroo provides. The key idea here is to alert only a single person at a time and escalate to others in the Gluroo exactly as needed. So here we have Sweetie on the left with a blood glucose level of 71, and she gets a new sensor reading of 67, which triggers a low alert. See the notification on the top of her screen. But more importantly, notice that there was not a notification sent to my iPhone on the right. The alert banner inside the app does show on the iPhone just the same, but only if the app is open, and there's no sound made on the iPhone, only on the Android phone. Now, during this first phase of the alert, anyone in the Gluroo can record what they did to address the alert. The in-app alert banner lists only the actions likely to be logged for high, and the device notification lets you record a corrective action easily from outside the app. But in this example, we pretend she didn't notice the alert and we wait. So after 3 minutes, and I sped it up to 1 minute for this demo, My iPhone at the right gets that alert escalated to it. I can then easily record the corrective action we took, 4 ounces of juice, and that new message that gets sent dismisses the alert on all the devices. There's lots of flexibility around notifications, and you can control which alerts you get from your mobile device's regular settings options, as well as some additional controls inside Gluroo itself. Now, a bunch of Gluroo's functionality is in its drop-down status tab, so I'll give you a quick tour of that. There's 4 tabs here. The first shows details about food and insulin on board, using your prescription as a guide. The second shows devices, your pump status, and when your sensor and sight will expire. And the third shows recent statistics, including your time in range. Finally, the fourth is one of the places you can see Gluroo's comprehensive charting. Gluroo helps you track and communicate your prescription as well. We have a visual interface for day splitting that's actually kind of fun to use, and a direct manipulation interface for editing your carb ratios, insulin sensitivity factors, targets, or whatever for each of those time periods. Now I want to talk for a moment about some of our data integrations. We've already seen how it connects to your CGM sensor to get data in, but Gluroo also lets you specify a Night Scout backend that it keeps updated with the entries from your Gluroo event log. Gluroo also integrates nicely with DIY Loop. Here, we have Loop running on an iPhone on the right and another member of the Gluroo running Android on the left. A carb entry and the corresponding bolus entered into Loop shows up almost immediately on the Android phone so that you can follow a looper regardless of what kind of phone you have. Edits made in the Loop get propagated to Gluroo right away too. Now, Gluroo supports this integration in kind of an interesting way. It creates a Night Scout compatible interface that you can enter into Loop. So first we tell Gluroo our insulin delivery type is DIY Loop, and that instantly generates a Night Scout URL and API secret that we copy and paste over into the Loop app's Night Scout backend service. Now, when Loop thinks that it's writing to Night Scout, it's actually making a direct connection to Gluroo's cloud service, so the updates happen immediately for all in the Gluroo to see. If you like using Loop Follow, the Night Scout compatible API that Gluroo exposes works fine as an intermediary for that app. So you don't have to create your own Night Scout instance. The functionality is pretty complete, but only as a data store. We don't try to duplicate the web-based functionality and user interface of Night Scout. That's awesome, and we're not trying to copy it. We just make it clear that you're using Night Scout as your data instance, as your Night Scout instance. Now, Gluroo works with other care providers too. If you are the school nurse or have multiple people with diabetes you help care for, you can be a part of multiple Gluroos and switch among them just by long pressing on the profile in the top header to open a list of the others. If you're a diabetes coach, Gluroo has a web-based interface where you have access to exactly your trainees and can see their charts, reports, logs, and otherwise interact with them and more. The last feature I'll quickly highlight is inspired by my time at Google, which of course is synonymous with search. One of the biggest benefits of a good record of our historical behavior, and really the reason for a lot of this logging, is to learn from our past so that we can do better the next time. Gluroo makes it easy to, say, search for sushi and see the events around prior times when our son had his favorite meal. You can look at the different log entries and open up an inline chart to see how well the estimations and treatments you log worked out at this restaurant or that restaurant or whatever. Using data to improve outcomes is extremely important. And Gluroo's first phase is about making it really easy and fast to get high-quality data logged while making diabetes suck less for the whole support team. Well, there's lots more to Gluroo that I consider table stakes for any app in this space. So I'll end this whirlwind tour. I'm delighted to answer your questions here now or via chat or email afterwards. Thanks a lot.